It looks really amazing. It's big, it's huge.
This one is also really beautiful.
That's enough.
Wow. Oh my God, it's so beautiful and big.
Good morning, everyone. Today on our list is to visit the Chichen Itza Maya ruins and to see the Kukulcan pyramid. And we are quite in a rush, but Sara forgot something, or we forgot something in our apartment, so she went back and I use this time to make the intro here. We are now going to the auto station to take the colectivo. It will take us about 45 minutes and it cost us 40 pesos each to get there and to be one of the first to buy a ticket and to see the Maya ruins. We are super excited how it will be. It was high on our list here during our visit in Mexico, so stay with us and let's go. We finally made it, we finally have our tickets, and honestly I'm a little bit annoyed because it took them so long. It's not really good organized and you have to pay like 572 pesos each for ticket. That's fine, that's okay. But then we had our tripod and they said no, you can't take it. No one knows why. Maybe I can attack someone with that, I don't really know why. So I had to pay 50 pesos more to put it in a locker, and then because I have a vlog camera I have to pay another 50 pesos, so they kind of rob you a little bit. I'm really a little bit annoyed, but now we are here and we will try to enjoy, and we see the pyramid in front of us and it looks really big, amazing. Yeah. It's big, it's huge. We're gonna try to take a photo. So
without our tripod,
but we will ask someone like we did before we had a tripod. So we are still super excited and we have much less money now.
So as you can see, we are in the front of pyramid, which is huge. It looks really really nice, and we heard that you should clap in the front of pyramid, so let me do it. Should bring luck, I think.
Or honor the gods, I don't know.
Okay, now your turn.
I see this huge pyramid, I have to think about the Maya movie Apocalypto and the scene with the stairs. While I was talking about the Apocalypto movie, Sara said, I never saw this movie, I want to watch it tonight. And I explained to her a little bit about the movie and about some scenes, and now she's not that sure anymore.
Yeah, we're gonna think about it if I want to watch it. Or I will just close my eyes when the scene will appeal.
Yeah, it is really a good movie. It's a little bit brutal, but it's good, and you also see how the people lived back then, or the Mayas.
We told you before that this place is not really crowded, but when the bus are coming, it is. There's
it's so getting really busy.
Many people at the moment. So once again, if you want to have this place almost for yourself, be here early, or I heard also 2 hours before closing. Wow, this one is also really beautiful.
One fun fact about Chichen Itza. Chichen Itza is not the name of the pyramid, even if you see the pyramid always connected with the name. The name of the pyramid is Kukulcan, I guess is the right pronunciation, but Chichen Itza is the whole area here.
You can get to Chichen Itza from different places like Tulum, Playa del Carmen, Cancun, but in our opinion the best way is to get here from Valladolid, because you can only take one ride with the Colectivo, It's going to take only 45 minutes and it's quite cheap also.
Today we are doing a lot of history, and another interesting fact about Chichen Itza is that it's one of the 7 new world wonders and also UNESCO World Heritage.
When I'm looking on a site like this, I'm always wondering how did they build this? I mean, they didn't have any machines, they didn't have any hammers, I think, I don't know. And they still managed to build such a beautiful and huge pyramid, which is still standing here after so many years.
To get to Chichen Itza, we took the colectivo, and as we said, we paid 40 pesos each. And the colectivo took us, it's like a small bus, took us next to the main entrance. But now to go back, we will take a bigger bus, which is called Oriente, and this one will take us back for 39 pesos each. First, when we came here, we didn't know which bus should we take or where is the colectivo. Then we saw some other guys and they told us they are also waiting to get back to Valladolid. We have our stuff back and now we are waiting for our colectivo. It was really beautiful here, a little bit expensive, but definitely worth it.
Yeah, so last time when we've been here in 2019, we didn't visit this place because it was too far away for us from Playa and Tulum and Cancun. But this time, while we were making the tour on the Yucatan, we decided we need to visit this place because everyone said it's so worth and it is. It was really interesting, really beautiful. So if you are thinking about coming here or not, it's definitely worth it.
We are heading back home now to have some siesta, to relax a little bit, because we had to get up really early. And tomorrow we are going to the Cenotes Suitun, right?
Right.
Hello everyone and welcome on our second day. Today we are going to the Cenote Suitun. It should take us about 15 minutes with a taxi, and we pre-ordered a taxi already, and the price should be about 120 pesos here from Valladolid. Call them.
That's enough.
What I have to mention is also when you come here and you buy a ticket here at the spot, you have to pay 150 pesos per person. But if you order already before, you have to pay only 130 pesos per person. So if you want to save 20 pesos per person, you definitely should pre-order online. The way down looks a little bit spooky. And the stairs are not easy to go down. But our main focus now is just to don't fall on our faces. But here we are, and here are already some people. Wow! So we were not the first ones. Wow. How do you like it? Huge, huh? We really suggest to get here early because on the internet it was written that it opens at 9. We were here like 8:30 and already a few people were here. So come as early as possible so you will have more time for you to take the picture, and also it's always better to enjoy this beauty here without or with less people. So we came here, gave our names to the guy, and once the plateau was empty, we went there, set our tripod and took some pictures. So I hope you like them because we definitely like the picture. Also, once you are here inside, you are only allowed to stay about 1 hour because it's really popular and a lot of people are coming, so you can't stay the whole day. So enjoy your time while you're here, and we are now definitely jumping into the water. As already mentioned, you have maximum 1 hour to stay in the cenote, but after 45 minutes we are already done, we are ready to go. So we took our picture, took a swim, and are now good to go. Now we are going to our apartment, pack our stuff and go to Playa del Carmen. So this is it guys for this vlog. We really hope you liked it. If you did, please subscribe, please hit the like button and see you next time. Goodbye.